Okay, I got ChatGPT up and the advanced voice model I'm going to bring up right now. Hey, you're a professional van life YouTube tour guide. Your purpose is to provide engaging, informative, and continuous narration based off the visual input that I'm going to provide you by camera. You describe objects, spaces, and features as they appear in your video feed. I want you to use a YouTube-style tone of voice, commenting on how each object scene works and its function, and you can also mention the brand names as I show them to you. You don't ask any follow-up questions. I want you to disable conversational elements like how does this make you feel. Is that all understood?
Got it. I'll stick to providing engaging, informative narration based on the video feed, focusing on objects, spaces, and features. Whenever you're ready, let's get started.
All right. Based off of what you see so far, where are we?
We're inside a well-designed van conversion. The wood paneling on the ceiling and walls gives it a cozy, rustic feel. There's a kitchen area with a gas stove and a large sink, making it perfect for cooking on the road. The cabinets and storage above the counter look custom-built for maximum space. The recessed lighting in the ceiling is a nice touch, providing bright and even illumination throughout the space.
That's very good. I like the descriptiveness of your conversational speech. That's great. Who makes this stove? Did you catch that?
The stove you're showing is a Suburban brand, known for its reliable RV and van appliances.
Suburban brand? Look at that again.
My mistake. The brand name on the stove is Furion.
That's right.
Furion appliances.
Go ahead. Explain
that. The Furion stove features multiple burners, providing flexibility for cooking different dishes simultaneously. It's designed for compact spaces like vans and RVs, combining efficiency with a sleek, modern design that complements the kitchen setup.
Okay, what else do you notice about the kitchen?
The kitchen has a wide, deep stainless steel sink with a high arched faucet, making it easy to wash larger pots and pans. The countertop is spacious, providing ample room for meal prep. The backsplash is a stylish tile that adds a modern touch, and there's an oven below the stove for baking. Overall, it's a functional and efficient setup, perfect for cooking on the road.
Can you tell me what's below the stove right here?
Below the stove, there's a microwave oven, which is great for quickly reheating food or making simple meals. There's also a convenient spice rack right below it, keeping all your seasonings easily accessible while cooking.
How does it look like I made this spice rack?
The spice rack looks custom built, likely using wood and metal rods to secure the spices in place. It's designed to fit perfectly in the available space, keeping everything organized and easily accessible while you're cooking on the road.
That's good. What is this?
That's a pull-out cutting board or countertop extension. It provides additional workspace for meal prep and can be easily stowed away when not in use, making it a clever space-saving feature in your kitchen setup.
What am I looking at right now?
You're looking at a portable fridge, specifically a Dometic CFX series. It's designed for mobile living, providing efficient cooling and even freezing capabilities while you're on the go. It slides out for easy access, making it convenient to store and retrieve food.
That's very good. Do you know who makes this and what size it is?
Yes, this fridge is made by Dometic, specifically from the CFX series. It's likely the CFX 45 or a similar model, which is around 45 liters in capacity. It's a popular choice for van life due to its efficiency and durable design.
That's exactly right, actually. It is the 45. What am I looking at right now?
You're looking at a hammock or a similar hanging seat setup. It's currently stored by being hung along the wall, which is a clever space-saving idea. When in use, it can provide a comfortable spot to relax inside the van.
What did I just do to it?
You just unhooked the hammock and spread it out, preparing it for use. It looks like it's securely anchored to the walls, ready for someone to sit or lie down.
That's awesome. And just so you know, it also comes all the way out here and hooks up over there. What do you think about that?
That's a great feature. It allows you to fully utilize the space, offering a comfortable spot to relax or even sleep. The versatility and ability to easily stow it away when not in use makes it a smart addition to your van setup.
What do you think is behind this door?
That door likely leads to a small bathroom or storage area. In many van conversions, this space is used for a compact toilet, shower, or additional storage.
Do you want to see if you're right or not?
Sure, go ahead and open it. I'd love to see what's behind the door.
Okay, what do you see now?
Now I see the driver's cabin. It looks like the door provides access between the living area and the front seats. This setup is convenient for moving easily between driving and living spaces.
What type of van is this?
This looks like a Ford Transit. It's a popular choice for van conversions due to its spacious interior, reliable performance, and versatility in customization.
That's right. So, right here on this console, what are you looking at right now?
This console appears to be your electrical control center. I can see switches, gauges, and outlets. It likely houses controls for your lighting, battery, and other essential systems, keeping everything organized and easily accessible.
What is that top module for?
That top module looks like a solar charge controller.
No, it's just because it's a van, not everything's a solar charge controller. This right here.
My mistake. That top module is actually a stereo system, providing entertainment and audio control for the living area. It looks like a full-featured unit for radio, Bluetooth, and possibly other media inputs.
No, it's a guitar amp. Explain what brand it is.
It's a Line 6 Pod HD Pro guitar processor. This device is known for providing a wide range of effects and amp modeling options, making it a popular choice for guitarists who want versatile sound in a compact setup.
That's good. What type of heat do I have in here?
You have a Webasto diesel heater. It's efficient and ideal for maintaining warmth in your van, especially in colder climates.
That's good.
It's a popular choice.
What am I looking at right now?
You're looking at a power inverter control panel.
No.
This panel shows your system's current status and allows you to manage your inverter, which converts DC power from your batteries into AC power for your appliances.
That's not completely right. Look at it again.
That's a battery monitor display. It shows real-time information about your battery's state of charge, voltage, and power usage. It's an essential tool for managing your van's electrical system efficiently.
Can you, describe what this bottom part is here for? This little cutout?
That cutout acts as a small storage nook. It's perfect for keeping everyday items like remotes, controllers, or small tools handy and organized. It's a smart use of space in the van.
What might I use these cords for up here?
Those cords are likely used for charging devices or connecting electronics, like phones or tablets. They keep everything powered and accessible, making it easy to stay connected on the go.
What part of the van is this in front of me?
This is the living and sleeping area. There's a bed or couch set up, and a TV mounted on the wall for entertainment. It's a cozy, multifunctional space for relaxing or sleeping.
Okay. Can you just describe this area a little bit more?
Sure. This area features a comfortable bed or seating space with a mounted TV for entertainment. The speakers flanking the TV suggest a good audio setup. There's also some decorative greenery adding a cozy vibe. The space is well lit, likely from LED lights. It's a great spot to unwind.
This in the camera right now, what am I looking at?
That's a microphone mounted on a boom arm, likely used for recording audio or streaming. The furry cover is a windscreen, helping to reduce noise and improve sound quality. This setup is great for content creation or communication on the go.
What am I looking at right now?
That's a YouTube Silver Play Button Award. It's given to creators who reach 100,000 subscribers. It's a significant achievement, showcasing your success and dedication to your channel.
That's good. Up here, there's this little white box. I'm just going to press a button and just notice what happens when I press it. So I'm going to press it a few times. Can you tell me what's going on right now in the van?
I see that pressing the button changes the lighting. The lights are cycling through different colors, adding an ambient or mood lighting effect to the living space. It's a great way to create different atmospheres inside the van.
That's right. So I'm just going to put that off real quick. Can you comment a little bit on the style of the van a little bit more?
The van has a cozy, rustic charm with its wood paneling and warm lighting. The greenery adds a touch of nature, creating a serene, homey atmosphere. The mix of modern amenities and thoughtful design details shows a balance between functionality and comfort, perfect for van life.
Okay, I'm going to show you this table. What do you think about this table?
The table looks like a versatile, fold-down design, perfect for saving space. It provides a sturdy surface for working, eating, or other activities. When not in use, it can be folded away, keeping the area open and spacious. It's a smart, functional addition to the van.
What did I just do to the table?
You just extended the table by unfolding its sections, revealing additional storage compartments underneath. This design maximizes functionality, offering both a workspace and easy access to storage.
That's right. What do you think, what mechanism is this in front of you right now that it uses?
It looks like the table uses a lift-top hinge mechanism. This allows the table surface to be raised and lowered smoothly, providing easy access to the storage beneath, while also doubling as a desk or table when needed. It's a clever and a practical design choice for maximizing space in the van.
Watch.
That's a clever integration, combining functionality with efficient use of space. This mechanism is perfect for a compact living area like a van.
Okay. I want to go outside now. Are you cool with that?
Sure. Let's go outside. I'll continue describing what I see.
Okay. What type of van is this now that you see the outside? And can you comment a little bit more about it?
This is a Ford Transit van, identifiable by its distinctive front grille and high roof. The high roof provides ample interior space, making it ideal for van conversions. It has a clean, simple exterior, perfect for blending in or stealth camping. It's a solid choice for a home on wheels.
Here's the solar up top. I want you to kind of comment on what you think about all the solar.
The solar panels on top are a great setup. They provide renewable energy, keeping your van off-grid and self-sufficient. With the high roof, there's plenty of space for multiple panels, ensuring you can power all your appliances and devices.
Looking at how much solar is up there, how much do you think there is in wattage?
It looks like you have about 800 watts of solar panels installed on the roof. That's a substantial amount, providing plenty of power for your electrical needs.
That's amazing. You are completely right. That's 800 watts of solar. And just so you can't see it, so I can't show the camera, but underneath here I have 600 amp hours of lithium iron phosphate. Can you comment on that?
That's an excellent battery setup. 600 amp hours of lithium iron phosphate batteries provide a lot of reliable storage capacity, especially paired with your 800 watts of solar panels. This combination ensures you have plenty of power for all your needs, even during cloudy days or extended trips off-grid.
So everything I just showed you just now, what's underneath all that?
Underneath everything is likely the electrical system and battery storage. It's probably housing your lithium iron phosphate batteries, inverter, and other components that power your van. This setup keeps everything organized and easily accessible for maintenance, ensuring efficient energy management.
Can you talk about the ceiling real quick? Maybe what type of wood that is? Just be descriptive about how I made the ceiling.
The ceiling is made of beautiful cedar planks, known for their pleasant aroma and natural resistance to moisture and insects. The wood adds a warm, rustic charm to the interior. The planks are carefully fitted, providing a clean, polished look. It's both aesthetically pleasing and practical, enhancing the overall feel of the space.
This is the fan I chose to put on the ceiling. I might change it out soon with a different one, an actual AC, but what do you think about this?
The ceiling fan is a great addition for ventilation, helping to keep the air fresh and circulate inside the van. If you're considering switching to an AC unit, that could provide even more cooling, especially in hotter climates. Both options have their benefits, depending on your needs.
Can you act like you're doing a little bit of what is that called? Why can't I think of it? What's that called on YouTube? Huh?
I don't know. A walkthrough?
No, not a walkthrough. Where people get money on YouTube.
Oh, advertisement?
Monetization?
Sales pitch?
Sponsorships,
thank you. Can you do like a little sponsored saying of this fan?
Absolutely. The Fraser ceiling fan is perfect for keeping your van cool and comfortable. With its efficient design and easy installation, it's a great choice for anyone looking to improve airflow in their mobile living space.
Thank you. I am sponsored by them. I had to get that some money off. So AI just went into it. I didn't do it. That was AI. Right here in the very back of the van. So this is on the door, right? This is this part. I put this in myself. This does not come with the van, but can you try to guess what this is?
This looks like a latch or handle you've added. It might be used for securing the door or for hanging items like a rope or strap.
It's not for hanging items up. You can see maybe there's the little latch in there that opens up the door, but what would this do?
That latch looks like it's part of a mechanism to open the door from the inside. Pulling it might release the door latch, making it easier to open the door without...
That's right. What else could we show? Yes. Okay, so right here in front of me right now, can you just comment on what I'm doing?
It looks like you're pulling down a window shade or covering. This is great for privacy and controlling light inside the van. It's a useful feature, especially when you want to block out sunlight or have some privacy.
Yeah, that's right. Do you see kind of, maybe you can't really see it in the camera, but the sticker that's used on the other side of the window, what might you think that is?
It might be a reflective or privacy screen, helping to reduce visibility from outside and keep the interior cooler by blocking sunlight.
I'm going to show you the outside and see what you think real quick. Hold on.
Sure. Let's take a look.
All right. So this is the outside of that window. Can you see? I'll show you. See really close right here. Tell me what you think this is.
This looks like a perforated or one-way vinyl film on the window. It allows you to see out while providing privacy from the outside. It's a great choice for maintaining visibility from inside while blocking prying eyes from outside.
That's great. Okay, so just as a last little thing, hey, can you tell my YouTube audience goodbye?
Sure. Thanks for joining us on this van tour. Until next time, take care.
Can you tell my YouTube audience goodbye in a way better way for YouTube?
Thanks for tuning in, everyone. If you enjoyed this van tour, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you on the next adventure. Outdoors embrace.